Pat has one of the most critical jobs on the line. It's his responsibility to forensically check hundreds of kilometres of track, to hunt down broken rails and damaged joints that could cause trains to derail.
That would be a catastrophe. And that's one of the main reasons that we have to patrol this line.
If he finds any problem with the track, he has the power to close the line.
It's really critical to keep the train flowing and keep everything working. We're looking for broken rails, any sounds. Right now we're gonna hear for a bang or a sound, anything. Might feel something.
Pat rides in a specially adapted truck called a high rail. Just driving a regular truck along the rails to inspect the track will not end well. The rubber tires will slip and the truck will get stuck. A high rail is specially designed for the railway, fitted with an additional set of steel wheels front and rear. Pat uses hidden hydraulic pistons to lower these wheels onto the track. As the high rail rolls down the line, Pat feels every knock and vibration through the steel wheels as they pass over the joints between the lengths of rail. If he feels a bang, it could be a gap in the track. If not quickly fixed, a broken joint could derail a train, making this trusty workhorse a vital weapon in the battle to keep the freight flowing. Track inspector Pat makes good progress on his check of the line, until...
Well, I feel a little bang.
He hits a serious problem.
See if I can see something out of the ordinary. Oof! Think we got something here. That's what we call a pull apart, and then it could cause major derailment.
The railway is made up of thousands of separate steel rails. These are bolted together with a metal plate on either side of the joint. During winter, freezing temperatures can make the steel rails contract. This puts enormous strain on the joints, snapping the bolts and pulling rails apart. If these gaps aren't spotted and fixed, they can cause a devastating derailment.
And I'll have to put the track out of service.
Pat must now fix the faulty track and reopen the line to keep the trains rolling.
The RTC is so in tracks, but Pat's gear over. I would like to put the peg or spur out of service for pull apart, over.
No problem, Pat. We're heading there right now.
It now rests on the shoulders of foreman Darren Martin and rail worker Pat LaRue to try and get the track back online.
This is a real emergency. You cannot let the train over top of it until it's been repaired. Then we have a derailment that's worth like millions of dollars, so it has to be done.
Darren's inspection reveals the power of an exploding railway joint.
They sheared the bolt right off. When they do break, it usually sounds like a shotgun there, and kaboom. You're going to the hospital, right? You're not going to be around anymore.
First job, smash the rail free from the frozen ballast.
You end up slipping with your track hammer. I've had it like 5-6 times now. Your thumb will just explode. It's not a job for the weak of heart, this kind of job, that's for sure there.
Next, bring in the high-powered hydraulic wrench to loosen the last remaining bolt in the joint.
Things are gonna get very noisy around here.
power tools can't persuade the bolt to budge.
The bolt is bent, so it won't come apart no more. So I have to go to my next step here. I'm gonna put the rail saw on and I'm gonna cut the bolt off.
Darren must work fast to fix and clear the tracks to allow the next train to pass through. But the brutal conditions slow down every stage of the fix. The hydraulic hose needed to power the saw is frozen solid.
See the inside of your fitting? It's frozen open.
Darren can't afford any delay. The hose must be thawed fast. He has to improvise to get his rail saw up and running.
And now I have to go put it in the heater, the side of my truck. This is how Northern Ontario, you have to do a lot of stuff to get them to work. Nothing ever works very good when it's cold. Any other time we would put it in the back seat of the truck and we would let it just sit there for maybe a half an hour, but it's an emergency, we don't have time, so this is the emergency way we do it. We cannot delay this train, we have to get this done as fast as we can. And now, thawed out, ready to go. 2-3 minute fix. And now, there it is. Gonna be a little bit of sparks.
Finally, the faulty joint is disassembled and Darren can remove the steel clamps, called anchors, that hold the rails straight on the timber ties.
My coworker, Pat, is taking off the anchors. And that's how you do it. Knock them off with a hammer.
Now, Darren and Pat must cut out the broken section of track to slot in a new steel rail.
We'll put the new one in and we'll be good to go.
Darren must get his measurements spot on. If he cuts out too little, he'll cause a major problem when the new rail section expands in the heat of the summer.
I don't want it tight. I have a quarter inch gap there for play because in the spring and in the summer, the rails get bigger, right? I'm gonna do the best thing, we're gonna cut a rail.
It's critical the rail is cut perfectly straight, so they use a brace to hold the saw onto the rail.
Ready for the spark show?
Powered by the hydraulic system on Darren's truck, the rail saw blade spins at over 4,000 RPM and slices through the steel like butter.
Okay, and that's it. We're cut through the rail. Now we're gonna pull this rail out and put the other one in. I'm just gonna slide her down first, Pat. Watch your feet, brother. Okay, up we go. Just like that.
They install the new rail and leave only a quarter inch gap. Once the hydraulics are thawed out with Darren's patented method,
I'll warm it up again.
They can drill the bolt holes.
And like it cuts through a rail in a matter of a minute, right? You would never do that by hand, that's for sure.
They lock the ends of the rail in place with steel plates to form a fresh joint.
Just like putting mom into papa. In it goes there, and there we go. They're all in. Now they just need to be tightened up.
One final turn, and the new rail is good to go.
We're gonna get out of the way so the train can pass through. So now we're out of here.
The truck is fixed, and just in time. The freight train passes over the new rail without a bump or a bang.